How are you doing? So my name is Cameron Walker-Shepherd, also known as Movement Decoded. And in my background of movement, I teach mixed movement arts and cultures. I've got a background in different martial arts, Kung Fu, Wushu, Tai Chi, boxing. I'm a practicing capoeirist at the moment, dancing background, contemporary, breakdance, floor work, and a whole plethora of things that I kind of pull into the practice, yoga and stretch therapy, functional range conditioning to help sort of find the best little hacks and tools for us to have longevity in our practice, in our craft, in our art form, be able to stay safe, prevention from injury, and also rehab if you are feeling the slight little niggles here and there. So I'll show a few little kicks from capoeira that I practice, which is what we're going to develop into our smart hip session for today to bring range and fluidity and space into our kicks. So noticing here, we've got front kick, open up into the hips, really grounding through the hips, spiral lines, and our chamber kicks, our martellos. So there's some of the kicks that we explore in capoeira, noticing how it cross-pollinates into many different forms of martial arts, and how now we're going to develop that space, strength, and range into that area. We're going to start grounded into the floor, coming into our 90-90 shape. So here you want to be quite strict with the positioning. So if you're on a mat, or if you've got any lines for visual cues, please use those. We'll use dorsiflexion into our left foot. We start with the left leg forward, so flexing into the foot, shin running parallel to the top of the mat. That thigh really tracking down 90 degree angles on all sides, so try not to be sloppy or closed in. Really open up into the space. Let yourself get nice and easy into position. Explore into the range as your body just gets used to it. You want your right hip to slowly just ease down towards the floor. It doesn't have to touch the floor, but just relaxing that direction. Your left knee really wants to stay grounded here. So here, just acclimating into that stress response, essentially. And then from here, we're going to do something called a technique, pails and rails. And it's where we're bringing a lot more subtler awareness around the activation of our joints deeper into the hip. So not focusing too much on the length for now, just that range in the hip for the foundation to be strong for us to open up a lot more. So pails first, our progressive angular isometric lengthening or loading. Here's we square the belly over that thigh, let the hands frame over that left leg. Lengthen through the spine. So you want to have a nice tall spine. Imagine there's sort of a rod shooting up the spine, coming up the top of the head. So it's going to prevent me from flexing or rounding into the spine to compensate. So long through the body. Take an inhale. Fold deep into the hip capsule without rounding through the back. Meet that initial resistance. Pause there. And you're going to do is drive down into the ground as hard as you can for about 10 seconds. So push down with the front knee, the thigh, the shin, the foot for another 8, 7, really break through the floor, push 100% effort. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, inhale, keep pushing. Then exhale, release that contraction, and maybe you might find yourself fold a little bit more. Try to minimize this happening here, but re-lengthen into the spine. We'll do 2 more rounds, so push down for another 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, deep breath in. Completely release that contraction, fold. And we'll find one more, push down. For 10, 9, 8, max effort, lengthen the spine, let the belly track over that inner thigh. 4, 3, 2, inhale, release the contraction, fold. And we can pause here. You want to kind of settle in for at least 30 seconds. Maybe a bit longer if you do have the time. Just so you feel that the sensations of the stretch just subside a little bit into that outer hip. And then slowly easing out. So we're going to come towards the right leg now for the internal rotation in the hip. So we're going to bring the hands behind the back. And what you're going to do here is ground through. Keep flexing to your right foot, ground through the heel. And as you settle into the shape, keep this left knee grounded and down. So if it is raising up, either place a prop, a block or a foam roller underneath the knee so you can have it pressed on something, or just make sure you're actively keeping that knee grounded. So squaring your chest towards the right leg this time, and we're gonna do 10 lifts here. So inhale, exhale. 9, 8, and if you find that you're opening up into this leg, 7, and this knee's lifting, make sure you actively keep it grounded. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and here we'll lift and hold. 1, and hold here for 10. Actively drive the knees away from each other. 7, 6, 5, 4. Use the hands to support through the body. Lift tall. 2, 1, and exhale, release down. So now we'll frame over this front leg again. And this time we're going to find the rails. So the regressive side of our loading into the muscle here. Bringing strength into the flexion of the hip and the external rotation. So we're just trying to have a lot of freedom of movement around this ball and socket joint of the hip. So hands frame over this left leg, lengthen through the spine. Take an inhale and squeeze your knee, your shin, foot off the floor and lift up and hold for 5. We'll do 5 seconds here. 4, 3, 2, and release down. Lengthen the spine, exhale, fold. So if the leg is not lifted up at all, it does not matter. As you lengthen from here, you want to bring the activation and awareness here by trying to squeeze up. So if your squeeze up looks like this, perfect, that's what we want. If it looks like this, also perfect. If your leg's coming all the way up, you've got really open hips, strong hips, that's perfect there. You're just honoring the range of your body and slowly developing that strength, and you will feel the progress, you will feel into that. So again, we'll square the body, we'll do 2 more rounds, lengthen through the spine. Take an inhale, exhale, squeeze and lift. 4, 3, 2, and release down. And fold. Here we'll find 1 more here, lift up. For 5, 4, 3, keep squeezing the heel up. 2, 1, release down, re-lengthen, and fold. You can walk the hands forwards a little bit more. We'll pause here for about 30 seconds, and the belly track up and over that thigh as you lengthen it into the spine. About halfway. Your exhalations become about twice as long as your inhale. And notice, start to notice, really dive into the body and notice how the breath starts to change, how the body responds to the nature of the movement as well. There's a slow ease out of that. And then we're going to come into this back leg again. So we're just ease into it, just letting it know that we're actually going to open up into this side. Acclimate as we bring the hands behind the back, open up into the twist, wiggle into a little bit, feel where the body might be reacting a little bit, where you feel that feedback, and just breathe into it. And then we'll square the body back again. This time, instead of lifting through the knee, you're going to ground through the knee and look to lift this heel. Try not to bring the heel closer to the bum in order to create the lift. Can you keep it in this 90 degree plane? So if this heel isn't lifting, that's absolutely fine. It's bringing awareness to now the right area of the body to be able to facilitate that movement. So squaring the body, grounding through the back knee, lengthen through the spine, inhale. And exhale, squeeze up, we'll lift for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, release down. And lift, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, release down. 1 more here, we'll lift. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, release down. Square over this back leg. Last rounds onto our front and back leg here, a little bit different. If this one isn't quite accessible, you can just do the regressive lift. If not, we take it a little bit further. So just moving swiftly and lengthen through the spine. Inhale. Exhale, squeeze up from here, extend through the leg. Can you keep that external rotation, so the pinky toe tracking on the floor? Then square the foot, place down, fold over. So now we're coming into this hamstring range. Lift up, squeeze, externally rotate, bend into the leg, hover, and release down. Coming into the back leg, we'll do heel, knee, heel, knee, and then squaring into the front leg. So we'll do two more rounds each side, lift, extend, turn up, and release down. Lift up, turn up, draw in, and release down. Focusing on this back leg, inhale, exhale, lift, heel, knee, heel, knee. One more round each side. Lift, extend, turn, and down. Lift, externally rotate, draw in, place down. Other side, lift, knee, heel, knee. And then release out of there, rebound out the hips. And all you're going to do is exactly the same on the other side. So if you want to draw a video back, doing exactly the same there, we're just flipping into the other side, mirroring the same position, and going through that. And then when it starts to become a lot more familiar to you, it's very easy to whittle through. Just do a few rounds. It'll take up to 5 to 10 minutes for you to go through the series. You can do one round on each side if you've got a bit of time. Maybe you can double it up and do two rounds each side. But again, depending on your time, this is express smarter hips to develop the range of your kicks. Thank you for watching that. I hope you enjoyed. If you want to know a little bit more about my practice, philosophy of movement, you can follow me. My tag is Movement Decoded, movementdecoded.com. You can find me on the Warrior Collective site as well and their Instagram page. If you do want to tap into the full length volume of sessions, or we start to open up in a whole range of movement modalities as well, head over to Warrior Collective and you're able to get the full length packages there.